Hey folks, and welcome back to Pattaya. Got a lot to cram into this episode today. Tonight we're supposed to go somewhere pretty cool, a place that Lon wants to check out. That should be fun. Tomorrow she's got an appointment to get her license. We just got back from the bamboo place, buying some more supplies for the hut. We'll go into that. But we're gonna start here at the Healthland Massage and Spa. But it's not a spa day. We've come here to go to a restaurant. Funny thing about this place, I believe last episode there was a viewer that said, hey, you should check this new restaurant out. And it registered, and that was fine, and thanks for that. But this morning, Monday morning, I was going through the Thai social media sites that I visit to see where the good deals are, promotions. I do that almost every week. And this was on there, 20% off. I said, hey, what's that? I looked at it, lo and behold, it's the same place that the viewer just recommended. So the first month here is 20% off. That's the promotion. The name kind of stuck in my head because it's oddly familiar. The restaurant is called Lucas. That's right, Lucas. That's familiar. So we've ordered several dishes here. They've got some of the specialties are actually breakfast. They're open early. They have a breakfast, they have a brunch, of course, mains for dinner and everything. Kind of goes all the way up. It's, I guess it would almost be considered fine dining at the top end of the menu, but the lower end of the menu with the breakfast and everything, just maybe a little bit higher than what you're probably used to paying at most eateries in town. But it really does have a Mediterranean feel in here, the arched windows and the airiness of it. You can look out, there's a waterfall. There's a brilliant upstairs, a kind of a circular staircase, very grand, that goes up to a second floor lounge. There's a big bar up there and everything like that. So downstairs is more of the feel of a cafe. There's a whole cake case, a pie case, all that stuff. And well, I'm curious to see what the food is. It's not the cheapest place in town, but it's part of this huge massage spa, this day spa here. And this here again would be kind of like a place I went last year for a professional spa treatment, where you get like a 3-hour package, 4-hour package. I think there might even be 5-hour packages, depending on what you want, facials, massage, all that. And this is just right next to it, a separate, very stately though, built house. We ran out of bamboo yesterday. Lon's been working on the hut, and it's not complete yet. It's nowhere near completion, but it is really coming together. So I'll show you a little progress report, a little update on that. But we had to actually go get more panels for the roof and some more bamboo today. So a full update coming, but I'll just give you a little peek of what that is for right now. And then we'll wait for the food to come and we'll see what it's going to be. So wow, I'm stuffed. I think we both are. We started off with a calamari, a fried calamari, very lightly fried, battered. Came with a great big wedge of lemon, rather. Lemon's rather rare here. I usually get lime. I like a nice big wedge of lemon, and that's what we got. Lon got it's like an egg benedict, but it's called an eggs royale. It's got the salmon instead of the Canadian bacon or ham. Oops. Also, a lovely plate of lightly toasted rye bread was put out with fresh butter. I tried some of Lon's. We kind of shared everything, but I tried some of Lon's. Very nice. Very nice. The hollandaise sauce, a lot of the hollandaise sauce I get in town has a twang to it. This one was spot on. A good amount of salmon and a great big poached egg. I had a ragu, a beef ragu. It was linguine, perfectly cooked, just a little slightly al dente, and the beef, a stewed beef, that ragu beef just melted in my mouth. A gravy, not a tomato sauce, basically a gravy. Very nice presentation and everything. With the 20% off, I think it's a real value. That ends though, unfortunately, that ends tomorrow the 10th, so by the time you see this, it'll already be end. Sorry about that. I should have come earlier. But where we're going tonight, that is something you'll be able to take advantage of because it's just starting and it goes for several days past the release of this video. And the best part of it is during that time. So we'll look at that later this evening. We're going to take the bamboo home. And then tomorrow, We go and see if she can get her driver's license after the driving school. It's a follow-up from an episode about 10 days ago. So we'll see how that works out.
Great lunch there at Lucas. With food, drink, gratuity, taxes, everything, it was all about 1,400 baht, or about 38 U.S. dollar dues. But tonight, we've got a carnival to attend. So the carnival comes to Pattaya, kind of a carnival. Almost every temple during the course of a year will have one of these as like a fundraiser, but it's kind of what it is, a carnival. Lots of food, things for sale. Of course, there's temple things going on, a little religious element to it, rides for the kids. But this one in particular has some very good name entertainment coming on the 12th, 13th, and 14th. So we're in Jom Tien, Soi Bun Kanchana, in Jom Tien, right up by Sukhumvit Road at Temple Bun Kanchanaram. And this is just starting today, so it's going on for about a week. And the good entertainment is this weekend. So if you're watching this, you have time to catch it. Some very good Thai performers going to headline. But there's all kind of other little shows going on, side shows. Just the headlines are what I'm talking about. Every night there'll be somebody doing something. We've already played some of the games of chance. We're settled down here, have some food. I got a cola Slurpee. Just like a Slurpee, 30 baht for that. Lon got some kind of strawberry one here. I think hers is much better, actually. Look at that. I've got some braised pork here. Beautiful braised pork. And Lon's got some Khun Jin. The food, very cheap, 20 baht. I need 20 baht. The braised pork's 100 baht, but it's a pretty big bowl of pork. Falls off the bone. We don't need a whole lot to eat because we had that big lunch that we showed. But anyway, we'll look around the carnival here. We'll see what kind of things we can find to do. And I would play more audio. I would do more audio, but a lot of times it's music or it's loud talking like this guy. It's all right. I think you get the idea. Carnivals are not the quietest place. They're quite noisy. You know, believe it or not, I did one of these temple carnivals 4 years ago. 4 years ago, one of my earlier videos, I was in Bang Sen. And while so much has changed since then, one thing that has not changed, though, however, since then, is my ability to win at these games of chance, these carnival games. I do not remember this one from the last carnival. This is a balloon chamber. You reach in, you grab a balloon like that, you give it to the lady. There's a piece of paper in there, and that piece of paper will have a number on it. And with that number is supposed to correspond with a prize back there in her prize vault. So we got five of these. I think five picks, five balloons, which means five numbers, was only about 40 baht, a little over a dollar. So not a big investment here. So we've got our five numbers. We'll go back here and give a look into the prize vault, see what we can find. There's a 377, so we'll look for one that has 377. And if there is one, that's ours, whatever it is. You don't know what you're going to get. It's like a box of chocolates, I guess. But there's, 368. But long story short, out of our five numbers, I did not find any that corresponded. I didn't find any corresponding prizes. So we left empty-handed. I did see one with a 376, though. That was the closest we got. But anyway, there's another show just right around the corner. So by the way, this is all free. Free to get into the carnival. This show here is free. They have seats set up. A pretty good show. This is called Leke. Leke. It's a very type of Thai storytelling with... It's a musical folk dance is kind of what it is. There's a story. It's a dramatic presentation. There's some faux violence involved. Don't worry, these aren't real weapons. They're all actually family members. They travel around and do this. But Leke is quite a little bit of a show. At the carnival here, there's a little bit of extra jovial humor involved with it. So maybe not as formal as something you'd see at a playhouse or something like that. But quite funny. It's all done in Thai, but I think even... even if you don't speak any Thai, you can still get some enjoyment from watching it. They have these floral, I guess, leis or whatever you would call these, and that's, I guess, how they make their money. You can buy these and then present them to your favorite performer, and that's how they make money. But just right around the corner, there's something else going on. It was a lot of fun last night. We had a good time. Both of us really enjoyed ourselves. We've come out today to the land transport office. Actually, not bad to get here from the motorway. I've always taken my bike, and of course, you can't take a motorway on the bike. And I've always had to take back roads and all kind of different roads. But by motorway in the car, pretty easy, pretty nice. Anyway, this is her appointment day to get her license. She's supposed to be emerging from the building with her new license. We'll see if that happens. We went to the school about 10 days ago and she had 3 sessions of that. I think they did the test. So now we'll see. She gets the license. She's in there now and I'm waiting out here in the humidity. But afterwards, if everything goes all right, there's a really cool place around the corner here to get ice cream.
And in about 45 minutes, she did emerge from the building. We'll see if she has the license. You just never know. You might be missing a document or something. Looks like she's got something in her hand, and I see a smile. So that must be good. Yeah, there you go. I think she's got it. So we'll, with license in hand, we'll have to go see about that ice cream. Just a short distance away is Great and Grand. Great and Grand. And for 180 baht, or about $5, you can get a ticket to go into this ice cream themed park. It's all done in, it's very colorful and donuts and all sorts in there. After your theme park walkthrough, you can come into the ice cream shop and it includes an ice cream cone. So for all that, $5 a person, not too bad. But anyway, we'll enjoy our ice cream here on this humid day. But for this one, gotta go ahead and leave it off right here.
And as usual, I'll thank you for watching. And until next time, bye for now.